So you're a video editor looking to find ways to fade audio out. I'm going to give you three techniques that I use in Premiere Pro. And if you stick around to the end, I'm going to give you another technique that you're going to be able to add into a ton of other effects. Let's get started. Internet, welcome back. It's your boy Robert Teagarden here again with another tutorial. Today we are talking about three ways of fading out audio in Adobe Premiere Pro. If you're new here, welcome. I post content on a weekly basis on filmmaking tips and the business of being a creative. So if that's something you enjoy, stick around. I'm sure you're going to find a bunch of value. Let's pop on into Premiere so I can show you exactly what I'm talking about without wasting any time for me yabbering all over the place. Here we go. So as you can see here, I've got a really simple sequence set up in order to show you exactly how we're going to fade out this audio. This is just a quick gym setup that we did, and I've got some music from Epidemic Sound that'll aid us in our tutorial in terms of how to fade out audio. The first and easiest way to fade out audio is by adding a cross dissolve or a dissolve effect. There are two main ways of doing this, actually three main ways of doing this. And the one that I use most often is simply just going to the end of your clip here. If you have your little selection tool selected, you can hit V on the keyboard for that as well. You'll see as I get towards the end of this region or this little area, I can change what my cursor looks like, so I can kind of drag and drop these things around as well. As long as that's selected, I can right click and go to apply default transitions, and you'll see that it's going to add a constant fade or a dissolve onto that region. Now I can go back and kind of move this around. If I go to the end of this region, you'll see that my cursor changes again. One of the added benefits of using that selection tool, you get so many different tools involved, but if I pull this around, you'll see that I can kind of change the amount of time that that cross dissolve is applied for. If I go to the end, what you'll see is as this ends, my audio will fade out. Let's take a listen real quick. So there it is, just a nice smooth dissolve. I can change the dynamic or how long it's going to take. And as you can see, I can change the amount of time that takes by pulling that little cross dissolve thing back and forth. So that's tip number one. Another added benefit for this thing is using a quick command. So if I highlight that particular audio region, hit Shift Command D or Shift Control D on a PC, it'll add in those constant fades for me. Now, you have to know that it also adds it up to the beginning and the end of that audio region. So you'll have to go back and delete that thing one extra little step. But if you're a quick key person like I am, that thing's going to add a ton of value to you as well. You can also, just for shits and giggles, you can click on a regular video region, hit Command D, and it will do the exact same thing. But this isn't for this tutorial. It's for a different tutorial. Back into audio region, another way that I do this is by adding keyframes. Now, keyframes, I've done a whole bunch of stuff on how to manipulate keyframes in the past. If you want to check out those videos, go back in the channel and have a search. But if I hit Control or Command on my keyboard, you'll see that again, my cursor changes to this little white cursor with a plus sign at the bottom right-hand corner. That means I can add a keyframe wherever my cursor is when I click on the mouse. I'm going to go to the end of that region again, hit Command, click, and now you'll see I have two keyframes, not one, but two. And what I can do there is start to pull down this keyframe to act effectively as that same cross dissolve, except now I'm controlling every aspect of where that volume is. Now, you want to make sure if you go into this effects little square right here, if you right click, what you want to make sure is that channel volume, or sorry, volume level is selected. Otherwise, you're going to be changing different parameters, maybe the panaural or those sorts of things. You want to make sure that volume and level is selected. Now, that's selected by default, but if for some reason you're not getting the volume dipping, that's going to be how you're going to solve that problem. But as you can see, as we go back and take a listen, boom, it's giving us that crossfade that we want, or not a crossfade, we want to fade out the audio. Now, the cool thing here is that I can change where this key point is by dragging it back and forth. So where I want it to be can be, you know, further back or closer ahead. And if I click shift both of these keyframes and hit click and then shift in that order, click then shift, I can drag these keyframes along without changing their distance or without changing the actual gain of where my keyframe is. A lot of times when you're clicking and moving things around, you might make minor adjustments up and down just because you're not moving the mouse in a perfectly linear fashion. But if you hit click, then shift, you're locking those two keyframes into position where they are from each other in a distance standpoint. And you're also locking where they are from a gain or amplitude standpoint too. Another little quick tip for you as well. Now this thing is great. I'm gonna show you another tip at the end on how you can further manipulate those keyframes. So stay tuned when we do that. The last one that we wanna do, let me go ahead and delete these keyframes here. The last one I wanna show you is by actually going into the audio panel, going into audio track mixer, and being able to showcase with turning down this little carrot, you can see all the little effects and different busing that you can put your audio sequencing into. But this one is for audio track 5. Let's go ahead and rename this guy to music, just so I can better see what's going on. And now I can come up here, and if you see this little drop-down menu here, automation modes, if I want to fade something out, I can actually go to right, go back, and as I play this through the next time, it should actually dip down the volume depending on what I do with my sliders. So let's try it here. So I just manually faded that out. Let's see if it wrote what I wanted to in there. We'll see it on the fader. Boom, let's check a look at it again. Watch the fader go down. So that's a really handy way of physically moving faders. So if you came from kind of an environment where you're used to mixing things and pushing faders up and down, this might be your jam. I especially love this technique when I'm dealing with audio and I have to duck audio for dialogue. So if I'm playing music and then someone starts speaking, you can use the auto ducking features that are involved in the Essential Audio's panel in Premiere, but you can also manually move sliders up and down using that right function. Now, let's go back and I'll show you my final tip is when we have these handles right here, I'm gonna make this region just a little bit bigger so you can see what I'm talking about. And we're going back to our keyframes. If I want to have a smoother transition or further control the velocity in which the audio goes up or down, because remember, you can use keyframes to move audio in and move audio out. If I want to further control this, I can go into what's called a Bezier handle. So I go onto my keyframe and I right click and I go to Bezier. And now if you look closely, what we're going to see is I expand this region here, you're gonna see this little blue handle. Now I can drag this out to a certain extent, right? And as you can see, I'm controlling kind of the curve or the sine curve of what this looks like. It's not just a flat linear curve, like I'm plotting two points on a graph. I can actually control how fast these things ramp up and down. So if I had this Bezier curve, a lot of the techniques that I like to use is to come in here and kind of really swoop this down quick-like. And now that I have this thing, what you'll see is that it'll give a pretty aggressive dip down and then slowly fade out from that standpoint. Let's have a listen. So you have to listen carefully, but the audio really kind of stays in until about this point. Let's say that's a little too soon. I want to move the audio so that you can hear it a little bit longer. I'd just pull that Bezier handle out a little bit more, right? Pull that Bezier handle out a little bit more. And that way I should get more audio for a longer period of time. And then it just cuts and dips down. Now that Bezier technique is not something I use just for audio. I can use it on adjustment layers, on video layers, on effects layers. I even use Bezier handles when I'm doing speed ramping techniques as well. So that one technique is something that you can apply in a myriad of ways inside of Premiere. And there you have it, ladies and germs. There are three techniques on how you fade out audio with an additional thing of the Bezier handles, because we're just adding value all over the place. And speaking of extra value, if you want to check out this video right here on how to add an echo effect when you're ending your audio sequencing. I'll see you guys in the next one. This is T-Garden with another video in a can. Peace.